Files are really important to know the health of your organization. Knowing which files are where and who's accessed them last, what state they're in, is really, really critical. So maybe you're moving things around with SFTP, moving files from A to B, and you need to know what state they're in and if things are getting stuck. Perhaps you want to make sure that you aren't creating too many files in certain directories or too few. Maybe you're adding data to files over time, like log files, and you need to know when they get too big. Maybe you're doing the opposite and you need to remove content from files and you want to make sure they're actually getting smaller. The OpenTelemetry filestats receiver monitors files and folders and emits metrics to provide you with this information. So let's see that in action. The filestats receiver emits a number of metrics. So before I get into the hands-on, let's actually understand what metrics are available to you. So two of these are on by default, and the rest you'll actually have to enable. The default metrics are file.mtime and file.size. File.mtime is defined as the elapsed time since the last modification of the file or folder in seconds since the epoch, which of course is, 1st of January 1970. This metric tracks the metadata changes, so if permissions are changed on the file or the file is renamed, that will also be reflected. File.size is, of course, the size of the file in bytes on the disk. And the optional metrics are file.atime, file.ctime, and file.count. So file.atime is the elapsed time since the last access, that's the A, of the file, in seconds since the epoch. File.ctime is defined as the elapsed time since the last change of the file. Makes sense. Again, in seconds since the epoch. And like file.mtime, this metric tracks the metadata changes like permissions and renaming of the files. So just mentioning those metrics has probably already given you ideas about scenarios. So let's jump straight into it. First up, I'm going to configure the collector. The collector, as you know, is configured by a YAML file. And in this case, I'm enabling the filestats receiver. I'm using the contrib distribution, by the way, so check if your distribution has the filestats receiver. The contrib one does. I'm enabling it with the filestats receiver, and I'm including any files in temp/files, and I'm telling the collector to collect those metrics, those statistics, every 10 seconds. And notice as well, I'm enabling one of the default metrics, file.count. For this simple example, I'm not processing anything, and I'm exporting the file to OpenObserve, which will be my backend where I store the metrics. You can, of course, use any observability backend that you want to. Now, OpenObserve needs an environment key, so I'll show you how to get that in a moment. But the last thing I want to show you here is the metrics pipeline, where we tie together the filestats receiver and the exporter. So basically, we're grabbing some metrics from the receiver and we're sending it to the debug and to our backend. So let's first of all start the backend up, and we do this by setting a user email and password. This is specific to OpenObserve, and as I say, we need an API token to send some data in. So let's go to ingestion, custom, metrics, OpenTelemetry collector, and you'll notice it gives you the string here. So I'm going to basically copy this and set it as an environment variable called open_observe_key, which you'll notice my collector is looking for. I do this because I don't want a sensitive key in a YAML file that could get leaked. So now that that's all configured, let's start up the collector in a new terminal window. And while that's starting, let's actually have a look at our files directory. So if I print my working directory, I'm in temp files. And if I show you the files, I've got a file called first.log, which is 23 bytes on disk, and a file called 2, which is 0 bytes on disk. So jumping back to our backend, of course, this will be different if you're using a different backend. Of course, I can view three streams, and I've got file.count, mtime, and file.size. So let's just go ahead and have a look at file size first of all. This is a little bit messy, but you can see the file name first.log and the file name whoops, okay, we'll do that. File name first.log has a value or a file size of 23 bytes. We know that. And similarly, file number 2 has a value of 0 bytes. So straight away, we've got statistics about our files. Let's make that a little bit more accessible. And this query is showing me the maximum file size split by the file name. So I can see the green line at the bottom here is 0 and 23. Now, if I go ahead and create a new file, let's call this third.txt, and I'll just put some content. Now I can see I've got three lines on my chart. 0, of course, for the file name number 2. The green line here in the middle is third.txt, which is 19 bytes. I'll verify that in a moment. And first.log, still 23 bytes. Let's just verify that third.log is, in fact, 19 bytes. Yes, it is. Great. And there you have it. It's a brief introduction to the file stats receiver for the OpenTelemetry Collector. I'll be diving deep into other OpenTelemetry components in upcoming videos. So if you do have a component that you'd like to understand better, drop a comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll put it on my list of things to do. I'll see you next time. Bye.